Nader Ahmed, you can, if you want to call me, you can call me right in Pal Talk so we can laugh at you. This guy, by the way, he is obsessed. He seeks attention. He's just a kid. He's a low-class person. He don't even have high school. He don't know what he's talking about. And like, even imagine, he called people. He claimed to be someone else. I want to debate you. And then we go, they find that it's Nader Ahmed. Hey, Nader, you want to call me? So just for a laugh. Do you want to call me? Don't tell me you don't have Pal Talk. Last time we spoke many years ago, it was Pal Talk. So I will open my Pal Talk so we can laugh. What do you think? Well, let us see who's running from who. Okay, I will open my Pal Talk right now. Is that fair, guys? I will open my Pal Talk right now. And you cannot say I don't have Pal Talk because this is how we spoke first time ever. Call me right now. And everybody will die laughing at you. All right, I'm opening my Pal Talk. Here we go. Can you give me your name in Pal Talk? I will text you. Come on, you cannot be Nader Ahmed then. Because this guy, I mean, he used to go to my room and he would spank him every day. And now give me your Pal Talk ID. Okay, I don't think this is him. Let us search, hold on. Okay, I found a guy, his name is Nader Ahmed. All right, here we go. I'm going to text you. It says you are offline. Text me back. Well, I just texted him. He can say whatever he wants. Here we go. This is Nader Ahmed. It says he is offline. All right. And this is my text. See it? Let us see the hero. We will wait for you. Potato. I'm waiting for you, Nader. Don't waste my time. It doesn't take 2 seconds to log in purple. This guy, he does not need to run from anyone. This guy, he does not know anything. This guy is not even a Muslim. If you saw his email, he wanna beat the guy. He play karate. And all Mohammedan, they play karate. All of them, they are Bruce Lee. I'm going to beat you. I challenge you to meet me there, okay? I'm going to come and break your bones. What a bunch of kids. But anyway, this is the guy who agreed that his prophet have sex with the goat. What do you want more than this? And then the Muslims, they start torturing him for saying that. All of them are the same. Osama Abdullah, he said to me that it's proven that magic is a lie. I said, what? He said, magic is a lie. I said, but the Quran says that. And the Muslim made an article about him too. I mean, anyone who come to speak to me, the Muslims, they torture him. Nader, where are you, man? Are you there? Until now, I receive no hello back from Nader Ahmed. He's a kid, you know, he's like a bug, you know, like, I want to tell you, I say, Nader, come on, don't touch my shoes. I want to tell you, I are running away from me. Nader, gee, leave my shoes alone. What Skype, you coward? What Skype? Go to Pal Talk. Get out of here. Just a kid, stupid kid. See, he made me go to Pal Talk, and now he don't want to go. And all his life is he's in Pal Talk. Suddenly, he don't want to go in Pal Talk. Admin, just a black man. We don't have time for kids. And what I want from you more after you agreed that your prophet have sex with the goat? Hello? I mean, you're priceless. You are the best. Forget about the rest. Actually, he's here. Hold on. Yeah, let us call him. Hey, Nader Ahmed. How are
you? Hello. Well, hello, CP. How have you been doing? After all these years, we finally meet. This is very good. I get a chance to meet you. How have you been doing?
Thank you. I'm very fine. So what do you want to say to us? Go ahead.
Yeah, so, you know, we've been having these wonderful debates on the Bible, Quran, and modern science. Mostly,
Quran, I have a few challenges. Quran and science?
Absolutely. We've been having these discussions and debates, and I have said Christian has been running away from this debate series because he knows that the Quran is in complete harmony with modern science,
okay.
And there's
Okay, give us one. Let's not waste time, me and you. So for some reason, your voice is cutting.
Well, you need to answer.
Give me one miracle.
Okay, listen. You have to. Why were you running away from me, from this debate?
But
people said, no. See,
don't
discuss.
Make excuses. We are here. Let's see who is running. Give me a miracle. Let us laugh.
Well, here's what I would like to do, Christian friends. I would like for us to have a public debate on this topic.
Abdul, do you want to debate? You are talking to me right now. Until we have that happen, give me the miracle. Everybody will laugh at you. You are playing like a kid. You call me, you claim, you can debate me. Here we go. We can do it right now. Why next year? Why next century? Do it right now. Otherwise, you are just a kid wasting my time. So I'm listening to you. Please, let us speak like adults. Are you going to debate me right now, or you will never do it?
Well, first of all, I will, if you want me to give you a scientific miracle right now, I can do that, but I think you should first answer why you are running away from me.
Well,
answer that to the people.
You
because
are the one who's running. I'm saying to you, let's do it right now. You said no. It's you who's running. Do it. Go ahead.
Let's do 10 minutes right now.
It's a crossfire. Debate. Everybody will hear us. It's a conversation. Go ahead.
Okay, here's the problem. If we don't have set rules, there's time limits,
friend,
things like that, then we're just going to be...
It's a free boxing match. Show me, aren't you the one who speaks? You're speaking, or you play karate, and you are good at boxing. Do your boxing, free boxing match. Go ahead.
Yeah. Well, I'll tell you, Christian Prince,
stop making excuses. The rules go for both of us. It's a free. Say whatever you want. Do whatever you want. Go ahead.
But I have a very good excuse. My excuse
from running from you
is this.
You are a coward.
Okay, let me.
You are wasting our time. Are you going to debate me or not?
Okay, what I cannot do, Christian Prince, is win a shouting match.
Are you going to debate me now or not?
Coward on the run. Okay, so we're going to talk about one scientific miracle, and then you're going to agree to debate me later on, okay? So
I am agreeing to debate you anytime. Here we go. I'm here with you. Go ahead.
CP, we need a format. We need equal time, and we need to share.
Don't call me again. You are just a kid. You don't dare even to talk to me. We need a format. What format? Be a man. You are the one who said you want to debate me. You keep saying I'm running from you. You are just a kid. You are not even equal to my shoe. You don't even know how to say your prophet name correctly. If I call you right now and I ask you to say your prophet name correctly, do you know how to say it? You don't. And you are the one who agreed your prophet had sex with the goat. What more I want from you? So either you want to do it now. Don't waste my time. I will call you one more time. Either we do debate now. Don't put rules. No rule for you. No rule for me. Speak as much as you want. Get me busted. Go ahead. Let me call you. So
that hurt my feeling.
Do you accept or not?
Yes, let's do a debate. I know you'll run away like a coward. So let's just do what you want.
Go ahead. Be a man once in your life and talk. Go ahead. Speak as an adult. Go ahead.
Okay.
What do you want to say to us? Go ahead.
Yes. So we're going to do one scientific miracle to prove that the Quran is the truth and you are actually following a demon called Christ. So both the Bible and the Quran actually answers a question on the issue of alcohol. Now, what's very interesting here, there was a study done. I don't have my desktop, which is shared, where I'll show you that study. But in this study, it shows that the Quran actually, Muslim, because of the teachings of the Quran, the Muslim women are 50 times less likely to give birth to somebody who has fetal alcohol syndrome. The study says you got to go to the Christians because of the influence of the Bible. So the question tonight, which Christian Prince needs to answer here, is, okay, so the book of the Quran and the they gave an answer to this question of alcohol. And when we look at the Quranic answer, it is a far superior answer.
What is the Quran answer? I don't know. You're not giving me the verse from the Quran, remember. We'll talk about
chapter,
that.
Well, I'm sorry.
Chapter what?
What did you say?
What chapter?
Chapter 5, verse 9.
What chapter?
Chapter 5, verse 9.
Chapter
5, verse 90.
Chapter 5,
verse
90. Okay, tell me about it. Go ahead. Now we know what you're talking about. Go ahead.
Okay, and then I'll tell you about it, but I'm following the rules because I know you will not run away from me and we'll debate on this topic. So that's the agreement here. Okay, so let me go ahead and do it. verse in chapter 5, verse 90, okay. It says forbidden is alcohol, any kind of intoxicant, gambling.
Okay.
So from a study here, they pointed out that Muslim women are 50 times less likely to give birth to a fetal alcohol because of the teachings of the Quran. Now, the question is here, which you need to answer, is how is it that the Quran gave a
bad Quran? Where is speaking about the alcohol is bad? Where it says that?
No, it says, for you, forbidden is any kind of intoxicant. And because of that...
Where it says it's bad for your health in the verse you quote for me?
That is bad for your health. No, it is completely forbidden for Muslims. This is clear.
Okay,
and from the study, again...
Another. I'm asking you a very simple question. You say that this is about health. I'm asking you, why in the verse never say anything about health? It says this is from Shaitan. That's all. Because it's from Shaitan, don't do it, correct?
Yes, this is from Shaitan. And so because, as the study concluded, it is the teachings of the Quran which caused Muslim women to abstain from alcohol. And so the question... from again is that how could Allah of the Quran provide a better response than Jesus of the Bible on the question of alcohol? That's a question you need to answer now.
Let me make it clear. I'm just trying to get a full sentence from you. So are you saying the Quran confirmed that alcohol is bad no matter what?
The Quranic position is that it is forbidden. Yes, it's forbidden.
I know it's forbidden. This is not a question. Are you saying that alcohol is bad no matter what? It's bad. Yes or no?
But I think these are irrelevant questions you're asking. You're running away from the study.
This is the topic. I want to know if alcohol is bad or it is not bad. Is it bad or not? I mean, what's wrong with you? So you are saying to me, Quran is forbidden alcohol. Okay, forbidden because of what? Because it's good or because it's bad? What?
You don't understand the question. I need you to take some time.
This is my question, not yours. The Quran forbid alcohol. Is it because it is bad or because it's good?
You're saying alcohol is forbidden Quran. Is it because it's bad or good?
Why you are in trouble? Very simple question. How many times I need to repeat? Listen carefully. The Quran forbid alcohol. That's wonderful. Does the Quran forbid the alcohol because it is bad or because it's good?
So the reasons why the Quran forbade, there's actually a reason in the Quran. They said there's some good that outweighs the good.
Why you are making a speech? I mean, the answer is very simple. Allah forbid alcohol because it's bad, or Allah forbid the alcohol because it's good. Which one? Choose one.
I've already given you the answer.
I want a clear answer. Is it bad or good? Is alcohol is bad or good?
CP, I need you to stop interrupting me. I know you're scared.
I know this is a point you are not able to answer.
One word.
Is it bad or good? You are the one who chose the topic. Everybody is my witness, and now you don't dare to answer. What's wrong with you? Okay, Allah forbid alcohol because it's bad or because it's good?
CP, you gotta let me. Don't interrupt me. You have to let me answer. Okay, we're gonna have an intelligent.
You're making a speech. I mean, the answer is very simple. You call me. You say it's according to science, proving that women they give birth and they have a defect in their birth. That's wonderful. That means alcohol is bad. So why you don't say it's bad? Is it bad or not?
You know, the issue with the Quranic position on alcohol is that there is some good in it.
My friend, is it you who mentioned to me in the beginning saying that science proved that most of women who give a defect birth, and you mentioned the word Christian specifically, the reason for that, the highest percentage is because of alcohol. So is alcohol is bad or good?
Okay. Your question, as I understand your question, you're saying that overall alcohol a good or bad thing? Is that your question?
I mean, this is even your topic, and you don't even dare to answer. You call me saying that because of drinking alcohol, women give birth to children who have defect in their birth. Okay, that's your claim, and you claim this is from science. That's wonderful. Now, I'm asking you, based on what you told me, is that mean? And based on the Quran forbidding the alcohol, does that mean according to Allah, alcohol is bad or good?
Oh, I think I understand your question. Your question is, okay, did Allah forbid alcohol for the specific reason of preventing fetal alcohol babies? Is
What's,
that your question?
No. What's wrong with you? You are in trouble. You are like a cartoon, Mickey Mouse. You're in the corner. You know what to say. I'm asking you, is it bad or good? Very simple. Don't tell me any reason. I want to know. Is alcohol, according to the Quran, bad or good?
Bad. Okay, just answer your question. It's bad. But there's a little bit of good in it.
Finally, you said it is bad. So how come the Quran says it is good? Here we go. This is chapter 16, verse number 67. You made me lose my voice. Repeating the same question. The Quran says that the alcohol is amazing, drink. It's the best. It's a miracle of Allah. Read for me the verses.
Are you finding the verse? I'm sorry, I'm not even looking at your screen. Well, did you want me to respond?
Oh, no, I don't want you to respond. You can call a friend. I mean, what's wrong with you? The Quran says, you said to me, it's bad a second ago. You said to me a second ago, the Quran says that alcohol is bad. Now, the Quran saying that alcohol is a great drink. It's even a miracle from Allah. It is a benefit for mankind. And you can change any translation you want. What translation you want to put for you on the screen?
Okay. Oh, okay. I'm sorry. I'm not even looking at your screen. So let me answer that if I may. Okay. And one thing I will require of you, Christian, do not interrupt me in my rebuttal. Because if we're going to have an intelligent debate, we should not be interrupted.
You're not even a rebuttal because simply you just said that the alcohol is bad. The Quran is saying the alcohol is amazing. I mean, can you even make a rebuttal?
Okay, so let me now respond without interruption, because if you interrupt me, this is an act of cowardice, and this is exactly what I'm saying. He can't handle me in this debate, so he's got to interrupt me. So let me now go ahead and...
We cannot handle you for sure. I'll answer how the Quran, the same book, saying alcohol is a sign from Allah, it's a great benefit for mankind, and this is amazing product to use. It's a benefit. You make good deeds from it. You make good money from it. You make good health from it. It is in the top of that. It's a sign from Allah.
Okay, so now you're going to let me speak, or you're going to run away?
I'm waiting for your majesty. Stop complaining about interruption. You can interrupt me too. Your duty, remember your duty here. Supposedly, you are going to show me your knowledge. And your knowledge is a joke. You are just a kid. You choose a topic, mentioned the topic, and now you do not know what to say. Because your God said alcohol is amazing. How you answer that?
Okay, I want everyone to understand, when you interrupt somebody, this is an act of cowardice. He's running away because I'm about to put the slam dunk onto him. So let me go ahead and answer the question. Mm-hmm. The issue is the Quran actually made it clear, in alcohol there is some good, however, the bad is the good. So this is what the Quran said, and the kind of reason that...
Just get lost. Get lost, stupid idiot. It's a waste of time to talk to you. It says in front of you, it's a good... Indeed, you made good nourishment of it. Indeed, if you have sense, indeed you are a donkey. You are a certified donkey. Obviously, you do not know your book. It's a waste of time for someone like me. I can put my toes in a chat room and you cannot answer my toes. Who are you? So when you say, I'm going to debate the Christian prince, I want to debate the Christian prince, you're a potato. The Quran says there's some benefit. What some benefit? I asked you, is it bad or good? And I repeated the question 100 times so you can think about it carefully. And then finally I made you say it. It's bad. It's bad. Chapter 16, verse number 67, Allah praise alcohol, claiming that he is the one who made it for us. It's for our benefit. You see, I just now, I give you like a bite. You know, like, you know, you want to bite my shoe? I give you my shoe. But as you see, even my shoe, you cannot even bite it because your mouth is so small. Potato. And if you want to talk about health and birth defect, I never saw birth defect as much in the Islamic countries because you married from your cousin. And the proof of birth defect is you. Look at you. I mean, if you are not the proof of birth defect, who is the proof, idiot? Should I call him back again or give him one more chance? He will make a rebuttal.
Why did you run away?
I'm laughing.
What happened?
We are laughing. We have to take a commercial break because you are a birth defect yourself. So now, are you going to answer or not? Don't make an excuse. Are you going to answer how Allah He says that alcohol is a great product and it is a sign from Allah? And then you said to me from the beginning that it is from Satan. Isn't it the other verse it says from Satan? The verse you gave me, chapter 5. Isn't it that verse it says that alcohol is from Shaitan?
Okay, well, I want to be clear. You hung up on me. You interrupted me. And this is a clear sign of cowardice.
Everybody is laughing. Listen, this is recorded. Everybody will laugh at you. So the verse in chapter 5, verse number 90, it says that alcohol is from Shaitan, correct? It is a handwork of Shaitan, correct?
Absolutely. It is a handiwork of the devil, which is found in your book, right?
Nope. Okay, so now how the other verse is saying that it is the work of Allah?
It is what?
The work of Allah.
What?
It is the sign from Allah. It's a work of Allah. So chapter 16, verse number 67, it says, it is healthy, it is good, it's a fruit, it's amazing, it's beautiful, it's a good, it's nourishment, and it is a sign from Allah if you have any sense. So how it is a sign from Allah, and then the other chapter you gave me, it says it is the work or the handwork of Shaitan. Which one we should take?
Absolutely. And so this, as you can see, Christian Prince is running away from the real question tonight on how it is the Quran could give a better response. Now, what he's showing, okay, but I can show internal contradiction.
Don't you stop it. Don't make me hang up on you because you're a kid. You're just a kid, literally. I'm asking you. The question is very clear. Everybody is laughing at you. You are stupid like your prophet who said that the penis of the man will be endless. And I assure you, agreement about that because you have a problem. Now listen, is it from God, this alcohol, or it's from Shaitan?
Okay, so as you can see, he's interrupting me. He's hanging up on me. And this is a sign of this from Christian.
Because I'm done with you. You're done. You're lost. I have nothing to say. I'm just giving you extra time. Listen, Nader Ahmed, you are here for one purpose, entertainment. You are just a joke. You are not a debater. You know nothing. What? So I'm asking you, chapter 16, verse number 67, don't make me repeat myself 1,000,000 times. It says that alcohol is made by Allah. It's a sign from Allah. It's a miracle of Allah. It's a great, it's amazing. And the other verse, the one you gave me, chapter 5, verse number 90, it says it's the handwork of Shaitan. So which one of them is accurate?
Okay, so one of the cowardice of Christian Prince, anybody can win a debate by interrupting their opponent, hanging up on them, and shoving questions.
You can interrupt me as much as you want. Still you can't answer. What is the answer? People don't care for you. You can cry as much as you want. People are laughing. Which one is made by? Made by Allah or made by the devil? Is it bad or good? I'm waiting for the answer.
I told you this guy is scared to debate me. The Quran makes it very clear.
For sure. We are scared of you, my friend. So for sure. I mean, there's no two people that want to debate about it. You know, my friend, everybody's scared of you. You are a crazy person, brother. So now, is Shaitan is the one who made alcohol or Allah? Chapter 16, verse number 67, says it's made by Allah. Chapter 5, verse number 90, it says made by Shaitan, and it's bad. So which one of them is accurate?
Okay, so the Quran does not state in Surah 16, verse 67, that the alcohol was made by Allah. You have lied. Now, do not interrupt me again. I did answer this question, as you can see. I think he's running away.
Read the verse for us. You said it doesn't say that. Read the verse.
I want it to be clear to everybody. He's running away. He cannot debate me.
Read the verse. I mean, we are having a debate. Oh, I'm asking you. Give me the answer. Read the verse. Okay, you are saying something is not there. It's in front of us. Does it say that it's a goodly provision? Okay, let me read for you. This is the Muslim translation. Okay, and a goodly provision. Do you see the word goodly provision?
Yes, that does not say. Okay, hold on a second. Anybody can win it.
Doesn't say what?
Clear. Christian Prince is a coward. Is it clear he cannot have a fair debate with equal time? He's refusing to do so.
I'll give you more time than me. I will stay mute if you're answering. You said to me, I asked you, is it a bad? You said, yes, it is bad. Women, they get babies and they have defect. Bad for sure is bad. Okay, the Quran, you say, and it's a goodly provision. Verily, there is indeed a sign to for people who would have wisdom. So according to the chapter 16, verse number 67, the one who have wisdom is the one who drink alcohol.
Okay. So, can I talk, or is this just your time to...
Stop crying. I'm trying to explain to you the question so you might answer. I'm just trying to buy time. You do not know what to say. Go ahead.
Yeah, you did lie to people in which you said that you said alcohol is from Allah. We have you on tape. After changing your statement, oh, it's just a goodly provision. It means that there's some good in it. So now you just kind of changed your original statement. So, yeah, you did get busted lying
here
tonight.
Can I talk? Okay, you just said, I said, this is from Allah. It says right in front of you, you donkey. It says it's a sign, it's a miracle, or ayat and ayat. You know what ayat mean? It's a miracle of Allah. Do you see the word sign? Are you a certified donkey like your prophet or you are not? You are. So it says here in the front of you, it's a sign for those who have a wisdom. The signs come from who? From God. Do you Muslim believe that signs come from Shaitan?
Are you going to let me talk without interrupting me?
So stop. Why are you saying we get me busted and this is not from Allah? The verse in front of you is saying this is a sign from Allah. So beer is from Allah. It's a sign. Black label. Brother and sister, we have with us. And by the way, the Muslim, they used to drink and they pray. And even the Quran made a verse about it, praising it. And then because the Arabs, they start laughing at Muhammad. He said to them, oh Muslims, Allah told me, don't pray when you are a drunk. Chapter 4, verse number 43. Oh, who you believe, don't go to the prayer when you are intoxicated because you are drunk. So Zakir Naik, Nader Ahmad, all the potatoes in the world, they used to go to the mosque with the prophet and they fill a pot around him. And the Arab, they start making fun of Muhammad and his followers. What kind of followers they are? Why Allah did not say from the beginning? And in the top of that, Allah, he praised alcohol and he claimed that alcohol is a sign from him. Why he did that? Because the Arab, they love to drink. You're my...
Well, no point of giving me the mic if you're going to interrupt me every 10 seconds. I mean, this is an act of cowardice on your part.
I'm just answering you. You made a statement. You said you got me busted. The verb doesn't say it's from Allah, so I have to answer. It says in the front of it, it's a sign from Allah. So do you agree it's a sign from Allah or not?
I have never run a shouting match in my life.
Listen. I want to answer. You see, shouting match, this is not shouting match, this is spanking match. You are being spanked. I want you to tell me, does it say in the verse a sign from Allah or not?
It's pointless. You're just going to interrupt. What's the point of now talking about
this? Here we go. It took me 5 minutes repeating my question to make you say that alcohol is bad, repeating my question 1 million times, and now you are going to do it again. So is it saying there that alcohol is a sign from Allah or I'm lying?
Okay, so let it be clear. I'm going to answer your question, even though you're jerking me around, you're interrupting me.
Are you going to answer? Is it a sign from Allah? Is it a sign from Allah or not? You see, I am not anyone you can play with. You are talking to Christian Prince. I hold you from your tail. Okay. I put you in the corner. And it doesn't matter how big the rat is in front of me. Still, you have no cheese. I'm going to repeat my question. Is it a sign from Allah as the verse saying or online?
No, it does not say it's a sign from Allah.
Then read the verse. Read the verse. It says the word sign there. The sign
there is a difference. Can I respond? Why are you so afraid to debate me, Christian friend? Please keep in mind when you interrupt people, anytime you want. That's not a debate. And that's
okay, really Abdul, in front of everybody. In front of everybody, which interpretation you like to put in the screen?
Christian Prince.
Stop complaining. Let everybody laugh at you. You want a Jalalain, you want a Tabari, you want a Nikati, what do you want? I will put them for you, and they will get you busted. You're a potato. So I'm asking you for the last time. I'm losing my patience. You're just a kid. Is it a sign from Allah or a sign from Shaitan? Here it says it's a sign for those who have wisdom. For who?
Yes.
For the one who have wisdom. So the Quran is saying it clearly that those who have wisdom, they believe in the sign, which is dream drunk.
Can I respond? I mean, can I talk? I don't know. You could just interrupt me for a second.
Yeah. I think I can talk about this. You are the best joker ever. I love you, man. I love you. You know, God created a lot of funny things. I love you for the sake of God, because you are the best joker. Are you going to answer or not? Yes. You see, how many times I need to repeat my answer? When the Quran is saying it's a sign by whom? Who is the one who is giving the sign?
Can I talk? Are you letting me talk, Christian Prince?
No, you're not allowed to talk. I'm repeating the question, you donkey. Is it a sign from Allah? The word sign is coming from who? Who is the one who did the sign? Who is the one who did that sign? Go ahead.
Okay. Okay, so now please don't interrupt me. The text of the Quran, it is a sign. As that, the text did not say it's a sign from Allah.
So
the text did not say this.
Okay, so it's from who?
What?
Guys, it's not from Allah. Okay, no. Finally, we got an answer. It doesn't say it's from Allah. It's from who?
Okay, Christian Prince, you are scared to debate me. It's very clear.
Coward, don't run, coward. I'm asking you. You say it doesn't say it's a sign from Allah. So are you saying that your God, he gave a sign from Shaitan? And he called it wisdom?
The text said, okay, listen. I don't want you to interrupt me again, Christian, because it's an act of cowardice. You're scared to debate me.
You are not answering. So is it a sign from Allah or a sign from Shaitan?
The text doesn't say, but now I'm done with you.
We just started, you donkey. Where are you going? What do you mean you're done with me?
Okay.
Listen, is it a sign from Allah or a sign from Shaitan? Prove it to me. Whatever you say, you have to prove it to me. What interpretation you like us to show to everybody in listening? Because either you are lying, and this is a sign from Allah, or I am lying, and it's not a sign from Allah. So when we say it's a sign, is it a sign from Allah? You said it doesn't say that, which means it's not. So can you get me busted, Your Majesty, Nader Ahmed, the scholar who have no, you don't have high school, can you get me busted and show me the interpretation for the verse? Where it says this is not a sign from Allah.
Christian friends, I have to go. I cannot believe you jerking me around.
You have to go. Well, mommy is coming. What, you want to change your diaper? Where do you want to go? Where do you want to go? What happened? No, you are in the corner. You are a potato, and you are a coward. You just admitted that Allah is Shaitan, because the Quran is saying this is a sign for those who have wisdom, and you deny that those who follow the wisdom, they are following the sign of God. You just deny that this is a sign from God by saying it doesn't say that. So you are a liar, and you are a potato. This is a topic you choose. And you don't want to answer because it's very embarrassing. Let us see how many Muslims will laugh at you about, and you are the one who says, who will debate you? Who are you? Who are you? You don't know nothing. Here we go. I repeat again. Don't tell me I have to go. Mommy, she will be upset. She will watch this video, and she will be upset from you. Be a man. Be the hero. So, is it a sign from Allah, or it is not?
I have to go. I want you to commit to a public debate with me on the topic.
This is the kid, Nader Ahmed, who go around and says he want to debate Christian Prince. This is why they don't dare to debate me. This guy, last time I spoke to him, it was maybe 12 years ago, and he admit he's a prophet, have sex with the goat. That's why they want to talk about it. He said, so what? Christian Prince, he ran away from me, Christian Prince. I mean, come on, this guy, he cannot debate me. You know, my name is not Dudu. You know, Dudu and Dudu, like Dudu, the Dudi, the Bada Duda, the Duda. You're a bit potato, you are a donkey. And this is the topic he chose. This is his choice, imagine. If this is his choice, this guy was thinking about it like he's scratching his ass for the last century. If I talk to Christian Prince, I would talk about what? I would choose this topic. It's very powerful. It's an amazing topic. He cannot refute me. No. It's wrong with you? You're a potato. I lost my voice talking to you. This guy, he looked like 60 years old. Thank God, otherwise the Muslim, they would claim that I'm talking to a kid. But he's a kid. I invite you to public debate. Are you going to do better in public debate? This is public debate. I mean, how public we have? We have 1,400 people watching. I invite you to public debate, okay? So, public debate where people will die laughing at you. People will fall in the chair. People will sue me for dying from heart attack. Last time I had a seminar, people fell down on the ground. The guy almost, he died from laughing. Laughing at your prophet. This is, alcohol is bad. And, yeah. Okay, but it says it's a handwork of shaitan, and it's bad. So how hear Allah praising alcohol? Stupid. Well, I was nice to him, but he have to go now. Because he saw what happened, you know. I have to go. You let me talk, okay? I'm repeating the question because you're not talking. You're not giving the answer. See how they try? They claim that they can debate you. They change the topic in the speed of light. This is why you have to hold them tight. Don't let them go. We don't debate with Abdul. We don't. We corner them. There's no debate with liars. Debate, it has to happen between two people have honesty. Muslims, when they defend Islam, they don't defend by honesty. They ask him, the guy, his name is Mimi, your God, Allah apart. He said, who said so? What do you mean, who said so? The Quran says so. The Hadith says so. The scholar, they say so. Who said so? All of them, they are the same. All of them, they are the same. Who said so? And here we are, the Muslims, how the Quran is praising alcohol in one place and making it the hand of shaitan work in different place. Very simple answer for that. In the beginning, Muhammad was trying to tempt the Arab who loved to drink. He said, this is a sign from Allah. It's a good provision for you. Drink as you wish. It's a miracle for those who have wisdom. And then when he noticed that people are laughing at his followers because they are a bunch of lousy people, drunk people, going to the mosque and they are falling apart, he made a verse, brothers, when you go to the mosque, brother, don't pray and you are intoxicated because beer is haram. Actually, he did not say it's haram. He says, don't pray when you are drunk. Okay, how in the world they can pray then? Because in order not to be drunk, you have to give them time. The Muslims, they have to pray 5 times a day. They are drunk all the time. And Muhammad himself, he used to teach Muslims how to make alcohol. There's tons of reference about it. Good provision? No, Abdul, it says sakaran. It doesn't say grape, my friend. First of all, it says from the grape, from the fruits and the grape, you made alcohol. So good provision is not the grape. The good provision is from the alcohol. It says, and you make from the fruits, the palm date and the grape, you make from them strong drink of alcohol, and it is a good provision for you. وَتَتَّخِذُونَ مِنْهُ سَكَرًا وَرِزْقًا حَسَنًا إِنَّ ذَلِكَ لِآيَةٍ لِقَوْمٍ يَعْقِلُونَ. It's a sign, a miracle from Allah. And if you go to the interpretation, you will see the interpretation saying, yeah, this is before Allah, he forbid the alcohol. How it's a good provision, and you make even good money from it. It says, rizqan, rizqan. Do you know what rizqan? And he make it rizqan hasanan. I don't make interpretation. We can go and read the interpretation, shall we? Well, Muhammad Saeed, let us give you the microphone of Nader Ahmad. Do you like to call me? We offer him to show the interpretation. He refused. Maybe you can do better. Can you? Do you like to call me? Or you are just a potato in the chat? And now the Muslims, they try to say, oh, this is not about alcohol. It says clearly, and you make from it. What do you make from it? You make alcohol. And then right away it says good provision. So what we made from it? Something good, a good provision. So they can say whatever they want to say. The Quran is praising alcohol, claiming it's a sign from Allah. Is it the grape sign from Allah? No. It's alcohol who make you go drunk. Anyone next?